Subscribe to Cooking and Travel by Dr. Papure Borua and press on the bell icon for all notifications. Good morning everybody and welcome back to my channel. It's a bhindi or a lady's finger recipe today. It's dahi wala bhindi. We're using dahi to make a masala, bhindi masala. So it's lovely and yummy. You can have it with fulkas, you can have it with parathas, or also of course you can have it with rice there. So for that I have taken around 10 or 15 lady's finger, chop them into these sizes there. Do not make it very small, keep it a little big there. And then I will need some butter and some cream. So 1 tablespoon of butter, 1 tablespoon of cream or fresh cream, and I'm using sweet curd here, so 2 big tablespoons of sweet curd. I will also need some salt and some turmeric, but apart from that I'll also need some dry spices. Here I have used 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, some coriander leaves, 1 big onion sliced into small thin slices there, and some asafoetida or hing. So let's start cooking. So I've heated up a pan there. I'll just drop in some, say 1 tablespoon of oil, which is vegetable oil. I'm giving or dropping down the dollop of butter there and let it just, you know, melt off, and then I'll start. I'm going to smear the piece of bhindi with some turmeric and some salt, and now put them into the pan. So this is, I put them into the pan there, and I'll just cook on medium flame for some time, say 4 or 5 minutes, till the rawness of the bhindi actually goes away. Just a little, medium flame, 2 to 3 minutes. So after frying them for almost 4 to 5 minutes, once they start shrinking a bit, then they're actually done, at least 60% done, and we remove them from the flame. In the same oil, now I'm going to drop in the onion slices there and give it a mix. Also wait for it to make a little brown there, and now I'll drop in the ginger garlic paste. Now we'll add the asafoetida and a little bit of turmeric and cook on. We'll also drop in the dry spices, all the dry spices, not the coriander, okay, all of them. I'm not talking about the coriander leaves, but also the dry spices there, all of them. And once they begin to get really, really dry, we'll add some water. I've added the water there, and then we'll fry it for some more time, till all the water actually dries up. Now we'll add the fried bhindi and mix it with the masala. It's very easy. Just mix it with the masala and cook like this, stirring for some time, say 1 or 2 minutes, and then we'll give in the salt. But be careful, we've already added the salt when we had fried the lady's finger or the bhindi. So let it be on high flame, stirring in between for 2 to 3 minutes. Now is the time to put in the dahi. I switched off the flame, whisked the dahi, and I am going to put on the dahi there. And then give it a nice stir. And now I'll again switch on the flame and let it cook covered for some time, say 2 minutes. 2 minutes, this is how it looks. See, the oil has separated, and now we'll add in the cream. Just a dash of beautiful flavor there, merging with the dahi and all the masalas. And now again on medium flame, uncovered, we'll cook for some more time. I'll just add a little chili there for the kick there. This will be a sweet and a tangy sort of a recipe, and something that will go very well with parathas. And of course steamed rice too. So with a dash of coriander, I can dish it out. That's my dahi wala bhindi ready, and the dash of coriander on the top completes the story. I hope you like this recipe of mine. Do give it a like and a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Thank you so much for watching.